and welcome. Let's get started with hunting out the hottest property markets of North India with my expert co-host Sameer Jasuja, founder and CEO of Prop Equity. Credible data, ground reports and exclusive interviews of realtors and policymakers. All of that is coming up to help you find the right deal on a home. On the show today, we'll have Dwarka Expressway in Gurgaon making headway. Top 5 construction developments coming up. Also in New Gurgaon, we'll look at investment options under 85 lakhs. Neher Par or Greater Faridabad, budget housing picks in 35 lakhs. Then we travel to Punjab's largest industrial town, Ludhiana, for luxury addresses in a crore and a half. Upcoming sectors of Noida for self-use residential projects in 75 lakhs. In Lucknow, a look at projects for options under 40 lakhs. And the Delhi Development Authority is set for an organizational overhaul to make it more buyer-friendly. To all your questions about when the Dwarka Expressway in Gurgaon will be ready and livable, we decided to examine this region in detail. We have gone on ground and tracked the entire length of the Dwarka Expressway to find out how much progress has been made ever since the legal breakthrough last year. Here are the top 5 latest developments from the Dwarka Expressway. Under the winter sun, things seem to be warming up on the long-stalled Dwarka Expressway. Gurgaon's Urban Development Authority, HUDA, has scaled up construction of the 18-kilometer Dwarka to Manesar Expressway in recent months. The 1-kilometer pending stretch of land inside New Palam Vihar, the epicenter of all of Dwarka Expressway's legal troubles, is soon going to get unlocked.
Firstly, the oustees of Dwarka Expressway who were supposed to get plot allotments are likely to get the allotted plots very soon. They were preferring sector 110A for their allotment, and that sector has now been cleared of all litigation. The government has got all the clear land in sector 110A to allot. They were all to be done by 31st of January, in fact, but it may spill over to March by the time the government allots the plots to them.
Earthwork is also in progress on many portions that were freed after the legal settlement of 2015. HUDA is also paying attention to branding this prime real estate area. New gantries have come up in recent days, welcoming commuters and property buyers. Maximum action can be seen towards the second half of the expressway, where a critical railway overbridge is being built. Ever since May of 2015, when the legal case over the Dwarka Expressway was settled, HUDA has been in full swing trying to complete the construction of this railway overbridge in Sector 37C, Gurgaon. HUDA is now estimating that within the next few months, this flyover to NH8 will be ready. Once this railway overbridge is ready, the Haryana side of the Dwarka Expressway will be a seamless travel. But while Haryana has been proactive these past few months, Delhi has disappointed on its side of the expressway. The Dwarka entry of the expressway is still to be acquired by the Delhi Development Authority.
The good news is that the UD Ministry has told the DDA to start negotiating directly with these landowners of this 1 kilometre, because under the land acquisition policy, there's a direct negotiation provision also. You know, Haryana on their part has spent already 3,000 crores to get this 18 kilometres up and running. If just for 1 kilometre on the Delhi side, this whole Dwarka Expressway cannot be used, it's very unfortunate, because over here on one side the NGT is hell-bent on getting the government to decongest NH8. And if just 1 kilometre of a stretch can hold up a decongestion effort of 22 kilometres, it's very sad, and it's been 10 years.
The Bijwasan flyover inaugurated last month was supposed to smoothen access to the expressway. But of what use is this flyover when the entry to the Dwarka Expressway is still to be cleared by the DDA? With camera person AJ Joseph, Vasudha Sharma, NDTV. So those were the top 5 construction updates on the Dwarka Expressway. Sameer, I would like to ask you, the developers that I spoke to for this story, so they're all gung-ho that, you know, this road is nearing completion, and they also have a message for our viewers that, you know, go buy, book a home now, because the deals, primary deals, are coming at a very attractive price point, and as the road nears completion, that won't be true. Do you agree with that?
Well, you know, with infrastructure coming in any area, the rates slowly go up. That's for sure. And that's been happening in every micro market, wherever there is some infrastructure completion that happens slower than later. But at the same time, you know, prices had run up quite a fair bit, and social infrastructure is still hardly there on the Dwarka Expressway stretch, where there is top developments of these developers are. So I agree with the fact that the prices are still quite compelling to get into the market from a long-term perspective, because as I see it, once the Dwarka Expressway is ready, there is some amount of livability that comes by, then social infrastructure will quickly follow.
Are the prices at a discount right now?
Well, if you look at price points which were bought by investors earlier, they are looking to sell their properties at a very low price, lower than the primary market price that developers are quoting, which is the right opportunity, according to me, to get into. Anything that you buy between 5,000 and 6,500 rupees, depending on the location. Mm-hmm. And naturally, 6,500 rupees has to be quite attractive, say a sector 109 or whatever. Mm-hmm. There is a good amount of upside that is possible. But I would say that with the state of the markets currently at which they are, both stock markets and real estate markets, and the way the global economy is functioning, and so is the Indian economy, I would say it's a good 3-year period before prices start to look up in a big way.
Okay.
So don't expect miracles to happen. Hmm. Expect a slow appreciation for the next 1.5-2 years. When I mean slow appreciation, I mean inflation driven appreciation, and then going forward you could get this big jump overnight. I would say in a 1 year period or a 2 year period, at the right time you'll get a 30-40% jump.
Okay, Sameer, let's also take up a question from a viewer who wants to invest in Gurgaon. Rohit Gupta, hi, what's your question?
Actually, I want to invest in a 2 BHK property in Dwarka Expressway, and I have a budget of around 60 to 65 lakhs. And I just want to invest into it. I have a home with me, but from the investment point of view, I want to invest. And I want to invest into a ready to move flat only because looking by the like the property is not delivered. So I don't want to get into all these things. Okay. I want to invest into a ready-to-move property. So if there are any
property in Gurgaon within under 70 lakhs, Sameer, Dwarka Expressway, does he have options there?
Well, that's the first part that I would not recommend Mr. Rohit to buy into Dwarka Expressway, because if he wants to buy a ready-to-move-in property, like I was mentioning earlier, that the infrastructure is very far away in Dwarka side, so you will not be able to benefit a lot because your apartment will be lying closed. You will not be able to rent it out even, and prices are going to slowly not be that attractive for you if you were to buy into that belt with a 3-year-old apartment when you go on to sell it when there is social infrastructure there. So if you want to buy into Dwarka Expressway, then you should look at an under construction property. Whereas if you want to look at buying into a ready property, then the new Gurgaon region, which is equally promising, though it's much lower rate, so the interest appreciation percentage wise will be roughly the same. That would be a better market for you to look at. And today the markets are over there at very attractive price points now, and a good amount of price appreciation is possible in the next 3 to 5 years over there as well. So if you look at the key data points of this micro markets, which is the new Gurgaon region, starting with sector 81 going up to 88B, there's 30 months of inventory overhang. There's 4,800 rupees a square foot of the weighted average price for the mid segment, and we're looking at about 8-9% annualized appreciation that this market has still been delivering. The three projects that you can consider are the Parkview Ananda by Bestech Group, Sector 81, trading between 5,200 to 5,400 rupees a square foot. This is a part of the Bestech's large residential development in the same sector. Projects is complete now and OC has been received, possession is under progress, so you're getting a ready product at 5,000 odd rupees a square foot. It has an excellent location around 500 meters from the main NH8. Then you have Vatika City Homes, Vatika Group, Sector 83 at 4,800 rupees. This project is 8 acres in size, excellent location, again 500 meters away from NH8, partially delivered already with few towers under construction and finishing stages, and is likely to be ready by mid-2016. This is a part of the 700-acre integrated townships, which include many Vatika projects besides commercial and recreational facilities. Then lastly, we have Gurgaon 1 by Alpha G Corp at 5,000 to 5,200 rupees a square foot, spread across 7 acres, total 7 towers with G+19 and G+26 stories. It's 2 kilometers from NH8 and 500 meters from Dwarka Expressway. Developers kept about 10% of the inventory to be released in phases after a later stage. The developer is also going to be launching an affordable housing project in the same sector. This is designed by Arcop Architects of Montreal, Canada, and a private equity fund has also got a large entity level stake in Alpha G Corp, which is a good safety net.
Okay there. So Rohit, for you in New Gurgaon, which are sectors from 81 to 95, we're giving you these three options: Parkview Ananda by Best Tech Group, Vatika City Homes by Vatika Group, Gurgaon 1 by Alpha G Corp. Arun Kumar with us on the line. Arun, hi, how can we help you?
Madam, एक query थी मेरी regarding मुझे एक नहर पार में जो है ना 76, 77 में जो है एक 2 या 3 BHK flat requirement है.
Okay, Arun had also checked out two projects, Era, the which was renamed Edel Group in sector 76, and a BPTP project. He wanted to know, is Era better or BPTP?
Well, between the two choices that Mr. Arun Kumar has made, we would recommend him to avoid the ERA project, primarily because there have been a lot of delays and there are litigations also.
And not just so this project, overall the company is facing a lot of
overall the company is facing a lot of challenges. So we would recommend you to stay away from this project, although it's spread across 26 acres, has good amount of amenities, trading at a much lower price point of 2500 or 2700 rupees, and that's primarily the reason, because you're taking a big risk. That's why you're getting things at a much cheaper price point, even though they are ready. If you were to look at the weighted average price of the market, it stands at 3700 rupees for the mid segment, and because we're talking about ready properties, inventory overhang is negligible, is almost zero, and the price appreciation is about 6.5%. Whereas the BPTP Park Floors project is a project that you can go ahead with. It's a 3100 to 3200 rupee price point project, much lower than the weighted average price of the market. And the best part is it's been ready since 2013. So livability is already there. 60% occupancy is there in the project. It has basic amenities. That's the slight negative, that not great amenities. And it's a big project of about 57 odd acres. But we have two more projects shortlisted for you that you may want to consider. Again, ready projects. Good projects in that area and doing pretty well. For example, Omax New Heights is trading at 3600 rupees. This project is spread across 10 acres and this project is got great amenities like a swimming pool, fitness center, rainwater harvesting. It's designed by internationally acclaimed architects. There's a 4-acre central park landscape by SMA Singapore. Then we have Royal Hills Phase 1 by SRS Real Estate, another project that's ready since 2014. With a price point of 3,200 to 3,400 rupees, a large area, 45-acre mini township, you could say. It has a shopping center inside the complex itself, well-defined parks for children, besides other amenities being offered as well. And project has good connectivity to the to Delhi, just 1 kilometer away from the Delhi Kheri Bridge. And this is another project that you could look at.
Okay. Sameer, what we're seeing here is very healthy absorption for this budget price segment. So Greater Faridabad seems to be doing well for affordable home seekers?
Yes, you could say that, that anything that is under 50 lakhs is slowly moving in Faridabad. Over 75 lakhs, nothing really is moving in that area. This has primarily been established as a now an affordable and a mid-market destination. And with the metro connectivity coming through, it's very difficult to get gated community projects at 3,000 rupee price points. Today, the cost of construction in itself goes over 2,500 even for low-rise projects. So really speaking, you are getting some of the deals at a song.
Well connected to Delhi.
Yeah, absolutely. So for any end user who doesn't want to take any chances, he's getting ready properties, he can move in right away, save on the rent, get housing finance, and get into projects at 3,200 to 3,400 rupees a square foot in the NCR region. It can't get better than that.
Okay, Arun. So for you in Nehrpal, look at these two options: Omax New Heights by Omax Limited and Royal Hills Phase 1 by SRS Real Estate. Coming up on the Property Show, the North Edition, luxury residences in Ludhiana. What are the top rated projects from this industrial town? And in UP, in Lucknow's emerging residential towns, prime property options. And for property seekers in Greater Noida West or Noida Extension, on our property tracker today, Gulshan Belina. Welcome back, you're watching the North edition of the Property Show. We're now discussing the property markets of Uttar Pradesh and Punjab. Ravi Pratap Rai on the line with us. Hi Ravi, what's your question?
Hi. Actually, I am looking for a project in the near Noida or Noida Extension, around a budget of 40 to 50 lakhs. It would be good if it is ready to move property.
Okay. Ravi had also specifically asked on his email that he wants to buy a villa in 50 lakhs in Greater Noida. Sameer, best options for him?
Well, he had also shortlisted a project called Lotus Villa, trading at a very low price point of 2400 to 2500 rupees in Sector 1. Well, we would request you to avoid this project because it comes under Gram Panchayat right now. Most of the land in Greater Noida is leasehold and hence villa supply is very restricted to few gated townships project only. Villa outside approved gated communities will essentially be village abadi land and not approved by the municipal authorities. That is something that you should keep in mind. Lotus Villa is one such project. There are row houses which are very small unit with very small unit sizes to fit into your budget. But it won't be our recommendation because we would recommend you to buy something with complete licensing from the authorities as well. The Noida extension market has got a very high inventory overhang of about 35 odd months. Lots of supply, 1,61,000 units coming up here in 212 projects. So, you know, with sales slowing down, this had to be the case. The mid-segment's weighted average price is at about 3,500 rupees and 10 odd percent is the annualized appreciation of this micro market because of the base being very low. There are two projects that we can recommend to you should you want to consider this micro market. Gore City 1, 6th Avenue, it's a project in Sector 4. Project is getting ready this year itself, 2016, that's a big positive, that's why it's slightly more expensive, 4,000 odd rupees. This is a part of a well-developed Gore City where more than 2,500 families are already residing. That's a very big positive, I must say. And the amenities here are great, swimming pool and a radiant club featured with reading rooms, cafe, latest gymnasium, sauna bath, steam bath, jacuzzi bath, billiards, table tennis, all the facilities that you can think of. And this project is available in the resale market. Lastly, we have Mahagun, My Woods 1, available through the developer and lower price point of 3875. The phase 1 also over here is getting ready this year itself. This is spread across 35 acres of land consisting of total of 26 towers. Construction is in different stages for different phases. Phase 1 construction is in advanced stages. Amenities here include a tennis court, badminton court, basketball court, party hall, areas to play volleyball, and the project is also IGBC gold certified.
Okay, Ravi, with your decent budget, you can find some branded developers in Greater Noida West. Look at these two options getting delivered this year: Gore City 1, 6th Avenue by Gorsons India, Mahagun My Woods Phase 1 by Mahagun India. Tushar Tyagi writes, I live in Ghaziabad. I'm interested to buy a flat in Indirapuram for my investment purpose. With rent, my budget is approximately 55 lakhs. I'm interested in Cloud9 or Angel Jupiter for a 2 BHK Indirapuram. Please give me your expert advice as to which project to invest in, which one will give me a good output in the future. Okay, Indirapuram, what is the price appreciation like here, Sameer?
Well, the price appreciation of this market is roughly about 10% and the mid-levels weighted average price here stands at about 5,300 rupees. Both the projects that you've shortlisted are very similar to each other. They're just off the Mohan Nagar Link Road and close proximity to each other, thus enjoying the same locational advantages. both the project are in terms of getting ready or nearing completion units or just having launch units, because both the projects are in phases. They are not the ideal choices in Indirapuram, but are definitely value for money propositions in a limited budget. So that's a call that you have to make because of the location. The first project, which is Angel Jupiter, is a project where phase one is at 4,800 rupees. The project is spread across 7 acres of land, located off Mohanagar Link Road, as I was saying, around 2 kilometers from the NH24. Has all the facilities like clubhouse, joggers park, swimming pool, gym, etc. Total land area of 7 acres. Cloud 9 Iris Tower by Rishabh Bridwell is another project which is roughly priced the same as a phase one, which is 4850 all inclusive. Project is located in Ahimsa Road, 800 meters off Mohanagar Link Road. Project is 2.54 kilometers and 3.2 kilometers from the NH24 and the Shipra Mall respectively. So good location, but a little off. Phase one, the one tower called Paradise is already delivered, and phase two has 4 towers which remain in finishing stages and are likely to be handed over later this year. And in phase three, developers recently launched 5 more towers. There is one more project recommendation from our side, but let's just look at some more key data points. Inventory overhang is 28 months for this micro market. As I mentioned, the weighted average price is 5,300 rupees and price appreciation is about 10-odd%. The last recommendation from our side is AVG Amba Homes by the AVJ Group. This is spread across 3.5 acres of land and consisting of only 2 towers, located off Mohanagar Link Road near DPS Indirapuram. Amenities here also include a clubhouse with swimming pool, kids pool, jogging track, kids play area, yoga center even, and power backup is also being provided.
Okay, so those are the options from Indirapuram. We'll move on to our next question from Amar Doshi. He says, I'm a chartered accountant. I want to purchase a 1 flat of 4 bedrooms at Ludhiana. My budget is about 1.5 crores. OMAX is one of my choices. Please give me your opinion about this project and any alternatives available in Ludhiana within my budget.
Well, OMAX is a very good project over here. We've been recommending it on the show. It's on the Pakhuwal Road at 4,000 odd rupees a square foot. If you were to look at the weighted average price, is roughly about 3,700 rupees for the micro market. But this project is getting ready this year itself, so there's a big price advantage that you get. Let's just look at the key data points before we come to the project itself. 13 months of inventory overhang for Pakhuwal Road, and we've got 2 more micro markets shortlisted for you because there are not too many options available in Pakhuwal Road. Firozpur Road is the other option, and Sindhwan Canal Road is the third option. Firozpur Road has about 8 months of inventory overhang. Again, few projects, only 2, and Sindhwan has a little bit more projects, but the inventory overhang is a little higher here at 26 months. Firozpur is the road is the most expensive road here with a weighted average price of 5,100 rupees for the luxury segment. Your budget is excellent, so you can go ahead with that as well. And Sindhwan Canal Road is about 3,800 rupees. On the price appreciation charts, very similar price appreciation. 6.8% or 7% for the Pakhuwal Road, and Sindhwan Canal Road is about 6.5%. As I was mentioning, Royal Residency is a good buy. It's a part of a 65-acre township comprising of independent floors, commercial shopping mall, a forthcoming 5-star hotel as well, besides office suite developments. The township is located on the main Pakhuwal Road. Township is just about 4.3 kilometers from the Ludhiana city and 5 kilometers from the well-developed BRS Nagar and Shaheed Bhagat Singh Nagar. Royal Residency is partially delivered project for under construction parts. It will take 1 more year time. Facilities here include an international spa, a nursing home, health club, power backup. Township also boasts of a shopping mall and other facilities. There are 2 more projects that you can consider. One is Crosswinds by Deepak Buildcon at 4,800 rupees. This project is spread across about an acre plus, acre and a half. It's a ready-to-move-in project with decent occupancy at present, offering a club with a gym as well besides the library and a lawn area. The project is located off Firozpur in Shaheed Bhagat Singh Nagar. And lastly, we have Hero Homes by Hero Realty at 4,000 rupees, spread across 16.48 acres. The project has got central greens, clubhouse with swimming pool, gym, sports facilities, amphitheater even. Project is located on the Sindhwan Canal Road in close proximity to the Punjab Agricultural University.
Okay, Sameer, for a company like a corporate company like Hero to come up with a project in Ludhiana, there must be something promising about the city.
Well, definitely, this is their literally you can call hometown. Punjab is where the Hero Group really comes from, and they are doing various developments in that area, they understand it very well. They have a brand name. Today, developers who with brand names and credibility and some track record are being able to extract some premium, as well as the consumers have that confidence in them, yeah, that delivery will surely happen. So that is one of the reasons why most most groups which are doing very well and are cash positive, I have diversified into real estate. They've really made some good real estate investments in the past as well to park their monies, and now they're converting that into developments. Godrej is a prime example. Bharti is another example. Hero is one such example as well,
okay,
where they formed their own development arms and focusing on real estate development as a core business as well.
Yeah. Okay, so Amar, in Ludhiana, most of the transport corridors are seeing a lot of real estate development, and we're giving you projects on Ferozpur Road and Sidhwan Canal Road. Recapping those for you, Crosswinds by Deepak Buildcon and Hero Homes by Hero Realty. Nalini with us on the line. Hi Nalini, how can we help you?
Hi, this is Nalini. Actually, I'm looking for 2+1 or 3 BHK flat near Gomti Nagar Extension in Lucknow, around Amar Shaheed Path. My budget is 40 lakhs. Please suggest some good options for me.
Okay, Lucknow in 40 lakhs, Amira, 3 BHK ready to move in flat.
Well, she had also shortlisted a project by MI builder called Russell Court. Now, there's a little bit of a confusion here, because what you wanted was a project that met your possession timelines, and this project is not getting completed by 2017, and it's also way out of your budget. So we think the project is good. If you want to wait till 2017 and can afford this project, then you can go ahead with it. A little bit about the project. It's spread across 12.5 acres, consisting of 15 towers, each of G plus 13 stories, located just off Amir Shaheed Path, and lies 4.8 kilometers from the Gomti Nagar railway station. Project construction is already underway and has reached up to the 3rd to 7th floor, depending on the towers. Developer also commands a decent reputation in the market, has completed quite a few projects. The micro market of Gomti Nagar extension stands at 26 months of inventory overhang. The weighted average price stands at 3750 for the mid segment, and price appreciation again is about 10% on an annualized basis. Should you want to go for ready projects in your budget, then please consider these two options. Omax Residency 1 by Omax Limited, between 3300 and 3400 rupees in the resale market, because the project's been sold out and has been ready for some time. 4 to 5 kilometers from Gomti Nagar, good social infrastructure in close vicinity like school, hospital and shopping. Project is located in Sector 7, spread across 14 acres. Project has three phases. Phase 1 possession is being offered. Lastly, we have Parth Adyant by Parth Infrabuild Limited, between 3600 to 3800 rupees, a standalone building of over 26,000 square feet area. The project has basic amenities and has nothing more to say, except that it's 1.7 kilometers from the Kashiram Harit Green Park, Gomti Nagar. And the project is in Sector 6 of Gomti Nagar Extension, adjacent to the Amar Shaheed Path.
Okay, Nalini, for you in Gomti Nagar Extension, look at Omax Residency Phase 1 by Omax, Parth Adyant by Parth Infrabuild. Okay, on that note, we'll wrap up our property queries with Sameer. Thank you so much for joining us and taking us through all the best property hotspots of North India. Coming up on The Property Show, will the new look Delhi Development Authority become more buyer-friendly? Stay tuned to find out. You're watching The Property Show, our North India edition. Poor quality construction and deficient infrastructure, the Delhi Development Authority has always been under fire from citizens for its underperformance and what many allege deep-rooted corruption. But now a structural makeover of the DDA is just a matter of time. The Madhukar Gupta panel set up to suggest ways to revamp the authority has submitted its report to the Urban Development Ministry, and a decision is expected soon. Unitam Ojha explains just why the DDA needs to be revamped.
These are home buyers who have bought property from the DDA or Delhi Development Authority, a 60-year-old government authority conceived to provide quality and affordable homes for Delhizans. One would think DDA would be reliable and more trustworthy than any private developer. But that's not the case. Charges of corruption, using fraudulent ways for property allotment and poor construction quality are some of the allegations which have been levelled against the government authority by thousands of its consumers over the years.
DDA ko pura paisa jama kara diya hai, lekin DDA aaj tak possession letter nahi de pa rahi hai, nahi de rahi hai.
There are certain sectors for which even the demand letters are not been issued till date. What is the reason behind the same is very difficult to understand. If you will confirm it today, when the demand letters are going to be issued, they will say another 6 months. What is the reason?
The gross inefficiencies of this nodal agency has been recognized and accepted by past governments as well.
A DDA earlier on was a monopoly. Was the planner, developer, regulator, real estate dealer, everything was DDA. And if you give me a bulldozer and tell me to bulldoze something, I'll bulldoze the DDA office first.
The mismanagement at DDA has not gone unnoticed by the current government, and that's perhaps the reason why the Housing and Urban Development Minister Venkaiah Naidu is all set to revamp DDA from being a typically bureaucratic Sarkari organization to a more performance and goal-oriented corporate one. The Madhukar Gupta panel, set up by the BJP government to suggest ways to revamp DDA, has submitted its report to the Urban Development Ministry, and a decision is expected soon.
We have to create these specialized expert domains. For example, my suggestion would be the whole engineering department of the DDA, which is highly qualified and very hardworking people, can be converted into a public undertaking like NBCC.
Skeptics, though, say bringing in clear accountability will be the biggest challenge in this revamp.
Accountability to the people at large is primarily the reason. It's a very old organization today, both in terms of people, vision, intent, ability, everything. So it has to reinvent itself with a much younger, sharper team probably. And one management reason could be the person or people at top do not have fixed tenures with fixed benchmarks.
Some of DDA's recent decisions, like the land pooling policy to tide over land acquisition issues and implement transit-oriented development to create housing stock along metro corridors, are yet to take off.
देखिए जहाँ तक flats की allotment की बात है, ये charge की corruption element उसमें involved है. ये तो बिल्कुल ही निराधार है, क्योंकि हमारे यहाँ बहुत ही fair and transparent manner में सारे draws किए जाते हैं. अभी तक जो भी past में छोटी-बोटी जो भी complaints आई है और रजिस्टर हुई है, अभी नथिंग हैज़ बीन प्रूव्ड कि जिसमें कि ये कहा जाए कि डीडीए में किसी प्रकार का इस मामले में कोई भी गड़बड़ होती है, इररेगुलरिटी होती है.
इफ द गवर्नमेंट एक्सेप्ट्स ऑल द फाइनेंशियल एंड एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव रिफॉर्म्स सजेस्टेड बाय द गुप्ता पैनल, डीडीए विल बिकम मोर ऑफ अ फैसिलिटेटर एंड रेगुलेटर रादर देन जस्ट बीइंग अ डेवलपर एंड प्लानर विद यंग टेक्नोक्रेट्स, आर्किटेक्ट्स, urban planners and revenue officers taking charge of DDA. In New Delhi, Oinitam Oja, NDTV.
With that, we wrap this edition of The Property Show. Write to us with your investment queries to property@ndtv.com. On Twitter, follow our show and our reporters to track the latest buzz from the ground when it comes to property markets. From Samir and me today, thank you for watching. Goodbye.